In the previous video, we discussed about the differences between microfilaments, microtubules, and intermediate filaments. If you want to watch that video first, the link is in the description. Now, in this video, we will be discussing about the microfilaments, or we can say actin filaments, and their polymerization mechanism. The microfilaments are for motility and contractility. And in microfilaments, the subunits are actins, or to be precise, these are G-actins. And we know the nucleotide to which the actin binds is the ATP. First of all, let's see the structure of G-actin monomer. In this structure, we can see it has 4 subunits, plus it has ATP binding cleft. The G-actin is a globular monomer protein. This monomer protein polymerizes into F-actins, which is filamentous polymer, a linear chain of G-actins. Here in this structure, we see there are 2 strands. The one strand has 14 subunits and the other strand also has 14 subunits. So one repeating unit consists of 28 subunits with 72 nanometer length. Now let's see how G-actin polymerization takes place in vitro conditions. There are 3 phases of G-actin polymerization: nucleation, elongation, and steady state. In this diagram, we can see we have G-actin monomers. And few monomers stick together, or we can say nucleate together, to form the first stable complex. As we can see in this diagram, few monomers bind together and form nucleus. And this step is the nucleation step of polymerization. Now next step is the elongation step, where we see the G-actin starts to polymerize into filaments, as shown in the diagram. These nuclei are rapidly elongated in the second phase by the addition of subunits to both the ends of the filament. It must be noted here that actin filaments grow faster at plus ends than at minus ends. Almost the rate of addition of ATP G-actin is nearly 10 times faster at the plus end than at the minus end. Furthermore, in the third phase, the ends of actin filaments are in equilibrium with monomeric G-actins. That's why this phase is termed as steady state phase. In this steady state phase, G-actin monomers exchange with subunits at the filament ends, but there is no net change in the total length of filaments. Now let's see the kinetic curves of the phases of G-actin polymerization. On x-axis we have time, and on z-axis we have mass of filaments. In vitro conditions, we see the initial lag phase, which is due to the nucleation. Then we have elongation phase, where this curve kicks up, and then finally the equilibrium is reached, where there is no net gain or loss in the filament. But if some short stable actin filament fragments are added at the start of reaction to act as a nuclei, elongation phase proceeds immediately without any lag phase or lag period, which is depicted in this curve shown here with the green color. In this curve, we can see there is no nucleation phase because we have already added some short filaments which acts as a nuclei, so that nucleation phase is skipped here. So this is how G-actin polymerization takes place with these 3 phases. I hope you like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Do consider supporting my work on Patreon, and also make sure to subscribe this channel. Thanks.